Hey, Andy here, and welcome to another video tutorial for Microsoft Word. In this particular video, I'm going to show you how you can insert your own signature, like you see here, into a Microsoft Word document. So if you're sending a letter to somebody or something like that, you might want to make it look a little bit more official, a little bit more personalized by inserting your signature. So I'm going to cover three different ways that you can get your signature into your documents. If you're new to the channel, please do consider subscribing and take a look at some of the other videos that I've got on my YouTube channel. And of course, after watching this video, if you found it useful, please remember to give it a like and feel free to comment. Let me know what your preferred method of inserting a signature into your document is. So we have a template letter here. This isn't something I have generated. I have found this on the internet. It's just a sample letter, and we're going to use it to insert a signature into this space at the very bottom. I'm going to delete this one just now, and we're going to start from scratch. So we're going to look at three different ways. The first way is using your cursor to create your signature, which I would say is probably the quickest, but probably the most difficult way to create a signature that looks really good. The second method we're going to use is we're going to use a stylus. So I have a little stylus attached to my computer via a graphic sort of drawing pad. They're very inexpensive. I think I got this one for maybe £20 or £30, and they have a kind of range of uses. So if you're doing a lot of note taking, for example, in Microsoft OneNote, then you might want to take handwritten notes. Something like a little graphic writing tablet might actually be useful. Of course, if you're using a device like a Surface Pro and you've got a pen, then even better. So we'll take a look at how to draw a signature with a stylus. And then the third method I'm going to show you is how you can basically handwrite your signature like I had a second ago, and then how you can basically bring that in from a photograph into your Microsoft Word document. And I would say this gives the best results. It gives the most authentic looking signature, but it's a slightly longer process, but I'll show you all of the steps for that. So first of all, let's take a look at how we can use our cursor to write a signature. Now, what you'll need to do here is, because we're in the kind of standard type form, you're going to have to add the drawing tools and the drawing tab to the ribbon at the top. So I'm doing this on a Mac, so I'm using Word for Mac, but the process of everything I'm going to cover today is basically the same if you're using the Windows version of Word. So let's add the drawing tab and drawing tools to the ribbon. Easiest way to do that on Word for Mac is to go up to the address bar at the top, or the system bar at the top, and you're going to want to go down to Word and down to Preferences. From the Preferences menu, we are going to be going into Ribbon and Toolbar. And whilst I'm here, I do have another video to show you how to fully customize your ribbon at the top and the Quick Access Toolbar so that it has only the options that you are using frequently and you want to be displayed. So I'll put the card for that above just now and the link in the description for this video. But anyway, let's take a look at Ribbon and Toolbar. And what I want to do is, on the left-hand side, I want to find the drawing tools and bring them across to the right hand side. In this case, they're actually already on the right hand side here, so I just need to check them to add them in. If they weren't, what I would do is I would search for them in the commands on the left hand side. If they weren't there, then what I do is go down to all commands, and draw should be down there somewhere. Although obviously I've already moved it across, but you would basically find it alphabetically underneath draw, and all you do is select it and move it across. So we've now enabled draw. All I'm going to do is click save, and you'll see that draw will appear up here at the top of the screen. So hit save, and draw is in there. So now I can close the preferences down. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go across to the draw tab, and you'll see we have some options. So I'm not going to go into too many details here, but basically we can click on draw, and then we can select one of our pen styles. You'll notice there's a little drop down arrow here next to this black pen, so it says it's 0.5 mil. If I click on it, we can change the thickness of it, and we can choose a different color or effects. If your color for your signature isn't displayed here, you can go into more color, and you can basically in more colors choose a specific color for your signature. In most cases though, for most users, black is probably going to be fine. So I'll just go for that thickness, and then all I need to do is basically try and do my signature, okay? So I'm going to do this as best as I can with a mouse, and it doesn't really matter if I've gone over my signature below because I can change that. I'm now going to go back into home, and what I'm going to do is actually need to turn off drawing by clicking back on draw. That'll turn draw off. Now what I can do is I can move this down, and you'll see I have added a signature which I am able to move around. At this point here, you'll see we have the little anchor here. That means that this is basically anchored to this position. So wherever the text around it goes, this will go to. It's not fixed to the page. So we can move it around if we want. You'll see as we move up here, it's anchored to this. So if I was to move that text down, the signature goes down. I tend to just leave the anchors basically in place. So we'll move the image into position. So you'll see there we have the signature. It looks okay, it's not totally authentic, and that isn't, by the way, my actual signature, but you can kind of tell that that's been drawn probably with a mouse because of the fact it's going from the kind of top to the bottom as I write Andy. With this, because it's an image or now a shape, you can go into shape format and you can make some basic changes with it in here, including like the color and stuff, but I'm going to leave it as it is for now. So that's one method of inserting a very kind of basic signature with your mouse. The second method I mentioned was to use a drawing pad tablet. So in here I've got the graphics tablet. I'm just going to move that along, and I can basically use that to draw. So that's the first method. Let's take a look at the second method, which is using our graphic tablet and pen or stylus to draw our signature. I'm going to remove this signature here. We'll just delete that one. We've got plenty of space. And what I'm now going to do is I'm going to go back up to the draw tab, and I'm going to click back on draw, and I'm now going to use my pen. So this one, I need to find the location, and I'm going to now draw. So there we go, I've drawn my signature. Now, I have to be honest, using these graphics tablets can be a little bit difficult at first. It takes a little while to get used to it. You can see by that, I'm probably not that experienced in using the tablets. So I could, if I want to have another go, uncheck draw. I could select these. You'll see these are independent of each other. So I'm gonna go back into draw, and I'm gonna try again to do a signature and try to do a little bit of a better one. So what I find difficult about these is you're trying to look at the tablet to make sure you're staying within the boundaries where you can actually write, but you're then looking at the screen to be able to see what your signature looks like, because obviously with pen and paper, you're just looking at the paper as you sign. A little bit more complicated with the graphics tablet, but there you go, we've added another signature in here. Once again, I can turn off draw and I can select it. You'll see it's now all one because I did it at the same time. You can resize it, you can move it around, you can make changes, but essentially we have we've created another version. Interestingly, you'll see my signature is now going from bottom to top here for my name as I'm writing with the tablet. So the third method I'm now going to show you is what I would say is probably my preferred method, and I think this is where you can get the best results. The other benefit of this is you can create a repeatable signature that is going to go onto all of your letters and is always going to look the same, and it's super quick and easy to do. So first of all, let me just delete this one, and we are going to insert our signature into here. What I have done is I have written on a piece of paper my signature. Now, if I was just to bring that straight in, so I'm going to go to insert, and I'm going to go to pictures and down to picture from file. I'm going to locate that signature just to show you what it looks like. So you'll see that's a signature photograph on a piece of paper. I'm going to hit insert, and it will bring it in pretty big, and we've got the background there, the paper in place. A little tip when you're doing this, because you're going to remove the background from the text, it works better if you use a slightly thicker pen. So a standard kind of biro, whilst it will work, sometimes you may notice that it takes a little bit longer for you to work on the background removal, which I'm going to show you in a second. So I would say using a thicker pen can make it that little bit easier. Anyway, we've brought our signature into our document just now. I'm going to go up to the picture format options, which are available because I have the object selected. If it wasn't selected, then you'd see we don't have picture format. So I'm going to click on the picture, and I'm going to use the first option here, which is remove background. So essentially what Microsoft Word will do is it will look at the text, look at the object in the background, and it will try to remove the background from the text in this case. So I'm going to click Remove Background, and it will do it quite quickly. Now, you'll see that it has left a purple area and a black area. So anything which is purple has been removed. We can see it has removed Todd from here, but kept Andy, and it's kept some little bits of the background here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom in using the zoom options on the bottom right, and I'm going to go down to the picture, and this just makes it a little bit easier. So you want to zoom in as far as you possibly can. Now what you're going to do is you're going to go up where it says mark areas to keep, and you're going to draw over the part of the image that you want to basically bring back. So it might take a little bit of time, but you'll see here it's now realized that there was pen there. I'm going to select that one. It's done the same here. And don't worry about the fact that it's potentially bringing in some of the background. We can fix that. But you'll see that we can go around this, and it has brought more of the signature into view. I'm just zooming in a little bit more here to make this easier. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the background removal tool options at the top, and I'm going to choose mark areas to remove. Now what I'm going to do is I'm either going to single click or do a little bit of a drag down to try and find areas to remove. So you'll see here anything which is blue I want to remove from here. I'll remove that little section. I'll click inside here. Now sometimes if you just click, it will remove it all. Sometimes if you just click, it will remove just a spot. So you maybe have to drag down a little bit. And what it's doing is it's basically looking around where you have made a removal point, and it's looking for any similar colors to remove in that space. So you might have to spend a little bit of time doing this to get it perfect. And what you've got to watch is that you don't actually remove any of your signature like I've just done there. So I'll add that one back in using the background keep areas, and I'm going to go into the removal tool again, and I'm zooming in further this time and just getting rid of some of that. When I'm happy with this, and I'm remotely happy or moderately happy, I'm going to click on keep changes just at the top here, and what that will do is it will take me back into my document, and it will leave the signature without the background as it has there. So that looks not too bad. Remember that we're seeing this in really large scale. It's actually going to be scaled down, so we may find it'll be okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click, and I'm going to choose crop, because even if we resize this by grabbing the points in the corner, we're going to have a lot of a boundary around it. So what we want to do is I want to right click and crop. And then these are your crop markers. So basically you want to get these as tight to your signature as possible. So we don't really need a boundary in this case. So I'm just bringing this down, and that looks fine there. And then you'll see we have the signature, and if we click outside, we no longer have lots of boundary. Now what I'm going to do is just resize it, and you'll see it constrains it as well. So it keeps the proportions correct. And there we have our little signature. Final tip here is if you're wanting to reuse this on lots of different documents, you can right click on the image, and then you can go down to save as picture. So I'll do save as picture. It's going to ask me where do I want to save it to, so I'll just choose my desktop. And it's really important here, don't save it as a JPEG, save it as a PNG file. Okay, so SIG1, and what that will do is it will keep it transparent, so we won't have the white background. And I'm going to go to save, and then if I just reinsert that, so I'll go to insert and pictures from picture file, we'll look for that pic or signature one, click insert, and you'll see we have the signature here. Now the only thing here is you'll notice it has lost a little bit of quality. Okay, so it could be when we look at our saving as a picture options, we need to check what quality is of the image. So it might be actually a better idea to save it when it's larger and then scale it down rather than scaling it and then saving it. So, sorry, I just accidentally knocked the signature there with my stylus. I'm going to delete both of those though. And what I want to show you is what I would say is my preferred method. So instead of using background removal tool within Word, which is okay, I want to show you a different tool that's free to use and I think gives better results. So let me just bring that up. And that is Adobe Creative Cloud Express's background removal tool. To use this, you will need to have an account, but it is completely free. And if you're doing any social media work, I would recommend looking into Adobe Creative Cloud Express, because you can use it to create really engaging social media content. I'll put a little link in the description and the card above just now to my overview of Creative Cloud Express, and I will have lots of tutorials coming soon. But with this tool, which I also have a video for, you basically click on upload your photo. And then what it asks you to do is it asks you to drop your image here or to upload it. And this tool is going to do the background removal for you. So I'm going to go to browse your device. I'm going to locate my signature, which is this one here, and click open. And I'll just leave it to do its thing. So rather than me having to manually work out where it's missed any of it and edit it, it will just do it for me. So you'll see it's removing the background, and there it has my signature. It has included a tiny wee bit here, which it's missed, but I could go into customize and I could basically remove that little bit and then save as a PNG. If I had got it perfect, then I could just click download, and you'll see once you have logged in, because it will ask you to log into your account at that point, you'll see it has then downloaded my signature here. As I said, I can click customize, I can take it into Creative Cloud Express and just remove that little bit, which isn't difficult to do, it takes 2 seconds, and I can then resave. But in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump back into Microsoft Word, I'm going to go up to Insert, I'm going to go to Pictures, Picture from File, and I'm going to use the one that I produced earlier and cropped already, which was this one. Click Insert, and I'll just resize it. And you'll see we've got our signature there. So that one looks okay, I'm happy with that. And the beauty of this is anytime I am now producing other documents, I can just insert that signature into my document. So there you have it, 3 different ways to add a signature to your Microsoft Word document. You can either do it with your mouse, you can do it with your stylus if you have one, or a graphics tablet, or you can bring a photograph in and remove the background either within Microsoft Word or within Adobe Creative Cloud Express. Hopefully you guys found that your video useful. If you did, please do give it a like and comment below. Let me know what your preferred method of inserting your signature is, or if there's any methods you use that aren't included in this tutorial. And also let me know your thoughts on the tutorial. Hopefully they are positive. Anyway, if you've not subscribed to the channel, please do give it a subscribe, and remember to tick that notification bell so you're notified about any of my other videos. I've got plenty of videos for Microsoft Word on this channel, so please do take a look at them. But thanks again for watching.